This week's video is a math puzzle, and it starts off with a story. We needed a bike rack. Our family was growing, the number of bikes we owned was growing, and we were doing all we could to make sure that the two-car garage in our Utah home could still fit at least one car. So a bike rack was high on our list. I thought I could use this opportunity to teach my older kids a lesson about business. The two oldest kids were about 12 and 10 at the time. I explained that when cities or organizations had a job to be done, they would ask for bids. Which bid would they take? The lowest, because it would save the city or organization the most money and still get the job done. So I told them that they would have a chance to earn some money helping me build a bike rack. They would each write down a bid and I would take the lowest bidder. The lowest bidder would be obligated to help until it's done and get paid their bid. The highest bidder would get nothing. I had them both write down their bid. Their two bids were $11.11 by the older one and $6.67 by the younger one. Okay, so here's the puzzle. What were my kids thinking? I mean, literally, how did they come up with such strange numbers? These really caught me off guard. I assure you that the numbers are not random, and that both kids arrived at the values with the same mathematical reasoning. Also, these are young kids. They're not setting up and solving equations, and any calculations they did were in their head. If you think you have a solution to this puzzle, leave a comment below with your guess on what my kids were thinking and how they came up with these values. I know this is not a typical kind of math problem, but it is typical of the kind of math puzzles that teachers often face. They're math puzzles at the intersection of math problems and student mathematical thinking. Teachers often have to infer how students are thinking based on student work or student comments, or even as little as their answer. Teachers can probe with additional questions to test their hypothesis about their students' mathematical reasoning. Sadly, you don't have that chance, but you can still use your mathematical reasoning and creativity to come up with an initial hypothesis about the thinking of my kids. Let's see what you can come up with. We will put up another video soon with the hypothesis I came up with after probing my kids' thinking, as well as a further explanation of the situation. I will add that there is a cultural aspect to this problem on why my kids did the reasoning they did. And there are some subtle hints in this video as to what the cultural aspect might be, but kids could have done the same reasoning for different reasons. We'll include additional hints in the description about once a week until we upload the follow-up video. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and share our videos. Be sure to follow Math the World on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Thank you so much for your support.